excited. I'm with Mr. Liam Bailey, who is my new favourite artist and tipped to be a big thing for this year. Liam, how are you? Welcome to the Red Room.
Hello. I'm well.
Did you like that introduction?
Bloated my ego.
Okay, just a little bit. Yeah. So for people that haven't heard your sound, people who live under a rock, what's your sound? What's your music?
I call it Mardy Soul.
As in, like, miserable?
Yeah, you know, I do, like, there's blues flavours, soul flavours, acoustic flavour, and it's all about mainly about one subject, which is, finishing with your long-term lover. Keep my soul safe.
So your current single, Blind Faith, with Chasing Status, yeah. How do you go about working with them?
Saul called me up and said that he got this song and this beat rather, and he wanted me to try some stuff out. So I went out and got Next, and then came back, and luckily on the Monday I was booked in to go to EMI Studios to just record some of my own little ditties, and just wrote it in about half an hour.
That's incredible.
Well, you know.
Well, me. Because kind of that song has been a bit of a chart success, actually, hasn't it? Did you think that it was going to be when you
were
recording
it? I knew
it was going
to be big.
Did you?
Yeah, it's obvious.
The polls of 2011 said that you're going to be tipped to be the best thing this year. How does that make you feel? Is it pressure?
You have to remember these things are marketing tools.
Okay.
And people will decide themselves whether they like it. Mm-hmm. But it is a privilege to know that people in the industry mm-hmm. consider my talent to be one of the best, because, you know, they pride themselves on their musical opinion just as much as I do and you do. So, yeah, it's good, but it's the people that will decide that, you know.
Well, Zane Lowe did say that one of your songs was the best he's heard.
Yes, well, he said it was the hottest record in the world. That was called You Better Leave Me.
And how did it make you feel when he said that? The hottest record in the world. It's a lot to live up to, isn't it?
No.
No?
No, it's not. Because I did what I did naturally. Mm-hmm. So, and anyway, you can't always bank on getting these things. And I don't feel the pressure, because as long as I make myself happy, I'm fine with that. But it is brilliant that you value his musical opinion.
Yeah, of course.
I'm not scared by it. It's not the be all and end all.
Okay.
If I got a Grammy, then that would be different.
Okay. So young, always making love. Leave Me. The video is very good. I like the French at the beginning. Why the French?
I had nothing to do with that.
Do you speak French?
Bonjour, madame. Je m'appelle Liam Bailey.
Very good.
I think the reason they did that was to stylize it slightly more.
Okay.
Because, you know, when you look at the video, it is stylized, but not as heavily as most major labels like their videos. And
subtle.
Yeah, and I think that the woman, the girl, the very pretty lady that is supposed to be my bird in it, she does have that kind of
je ne sais quoi.
Yeah, exactly. So, but it was a bit like my mates at Nottingham were like, "What's this? A bloody Chanel advert?" Or what?
So, kind of, what music are you listening to? Where does your inspiration come from?
I just remember sitting on my own listening to all my mum's records, which varied from the Beatles to Bee Gees mm-hmm. to Jimi Hendrix to ABBA, mm-hmm. everything. Michael Jackson was my be-all and end-all in the 80s.
So I like the Liam Bailey look, the fro and the moustache. Was that planned?
No, it's because I don't shave. I need to.
You think there's going to be people like copying your look?
No, I doubt it.
You never know.
Don't depress me.
Anyway, well, we're looking forward to the gig tonight because we're going to go and watch. Are you excited?
I'm looking forward to it immensely.
Do you get nervous?
I do, and sometimes I don't. And often if you don't get nervous, the gig's not that good.
Okay.
But that's one thing I've found. If you do get nervous, you tend to exercise all sorts of demons.
Well, I think you're going to be a great success. I honestly do. Thank you for coming to the Red Room and having a chat with us. And will you be back?
I'll come back, yeah.
Okay. Thank you.